Virtual surround, Dolby Atmos, 7.1 headphones, binaural HRTF, AD audio. I'm sure you've heard terms like these thrown around, but what do they actually mean for the average consumer? Well, strap on your headphones and let's find out. I'm taking these off. I can't hear myself talk when they're on. So all the terms I mentioned at the start of this video are related. I've planned on making videos talking about some of them in detail, but with the proliferation of consumer-targeted products using these technologies, I thought it would be useful to explain them at a consumer level. I still plan on making more detailed videos covering the professional side of things in the future, so get subscribed if you want to see that. Fundamentally, what all these technologies are doing is trying to create what we call an immersive audio experience. The vast majority of music and audio we experience today is in stereo, which is designed to recreate a 60-degree field of sound in front of you, similar to how you would experience sound while watching a concert or live theater. Immersive audio seeks to go beyond that and completely envelop you in sound. The most straightforward way to do this is to use a surround sound system such as 5.1 or 7.1.4. These systems place speakers all around you in order to allow sound to come from any direction. Unfortunately, surround systems aren't very practical. They can be quite expensive compared to a similar quality stereo system, and they take up a lot of space, essentially requiring an entire room for setup, and of course they aren't portable. Enter binaural audio. Binaural audio utilizes headphones, which are listening devices practically everyone has, combined with a variety of psychoacoustic tricks to create the illusion of sound coming from all directions. So, how is that done, and how can you experience it as a consumer? First, immersive audio has to be mixed. This can be done a variety of ways, but typically the most popular is to use an intermediary format. This way, an immersive mix can be decoded to any system like 5.1, 7.1-4, or binaural. One way to do this is with a channel-based approach. An example of this is ambisonics, which is quite popular in the professional audio world. You won't hear about it in the consumer side of things, though it is making its way into the game industry. It's an open format which uses a certain number of channels, typically either 4 or 16, to represent the directionality of different sounds. Those channels can be decoded using a matrix, which is basically just a fancy term for a set of mathematical equations, to any type of format, including the immersive formats we've been talking about, or even just plain old stereo. More common in the consumer world are object-based formats like Dolby Atmos, DTS X, and Auro 3D. Rather than encoding sounds into a channel matrix, each sound in a mix can be defined as an object and given specific coordinates in a 3D environment, which can also change, allowing the object to move around in space. The advantage of this approach is that it generally translates better to different playback systems. We would say that the object-based approach has better localization, meaning it's easier to distinguish where sounds are coming from. The downside is that object-based formats have limitations as to how many objects you can have. For Atmos, that limit is 128. One could argue that's more than enough, but it is still a hard limit. Alright, so we've got a nice fancy Dolby Atmos mix now, but how does that translate to headphones? Well, like I said earlier, there's a variety of tricks that can be used. Most of those are baked into what's known as an HRTF, or head-related transfer function. HRTFs are special models that describe how the human head and ear interact with sound. When we hear sound, we can determine its location based on which ear it reaches first, as well as how our head and external ears shape sound. This is what gives us a sense of directionality. We can use various terms to describe these effects like interaural time difference, interaural level difference, and pitch height effect. Now I want to quickly mention that there is a downside to HRTF, which is that everyone has slightly different ears and heads, which changes how we localize sound. The vast majority of immersive audio tools use generalized HRTF, which is an average approximation of the human head and doesn't work as well for some people. Some tools, such as Sony 360, can use custom HRTF, which specifically simulate an individual's ears and change based on the listener, but these tools aren't particularly common due to the complexity needed. In the case of Sony 360, they use a photo of your ear and match it to an ear model in their database using an AI program. Another thing to consider with HRTF and binaural audio is that it generally ties the sound field to your head. What that means is, as you move your head, the 3D sound image moves with you, which is not how sound behaves in the real world. This can throw off localization and affect immersion. In the VR gaming world, this is solved by the fact that a VR headset tracks your head movements and keeps the sound image in the same position as you move your head. There are other head tracking solutions that don't require a bulky headset like the Waves NX head tracker. Some headphones like the Bose QC35 have head trackers built in, and there are even tools that have you strap your phone to your head to use that as a head tracker. Now that you know all that though, how does the average consumer actually go about experiencing these virtual surround techniques? Well, there's a lot of ways. I'm going to break them down into two categories, decoded and encoded audio. Decoded audio is audio that arrives to you as a binaural format. Encoded audio is audio that arrives in a format like Dolby Atmos and can be decoded to binaural on your end. Finding decoded audio is really easy. Binaural audio is just two channels of audio, so it can be shared anywhere that stereo audio is supported. Simply look up 8D audio or binaural audio on YouTube and you'll get thousands of hits. By the way, so-called 8D audio is simply a stereo or mono mix that it's being moved around a 3D sound field using binaural techniques. The downside of these decoded approaches is that they lack some of the more sophisticated features of binaural audio like custom HRTF and head tracking, as the binaural image is baked into the audio. On to encoded formats, which there is a lot of. You'll see formats like Dolby Atmos, DTS X, Auro 3D, and many more. These formats are typically tied to some kind of delivery method, such as a game, a music streaming app, or a movie. There's a number of music streaming services that offer binaural audio. Some examples are Deezer, Tidal, and Amazon Prime Music. The two main formats in this realm are Sony 360 and Dolby Atmos. Unfortunately, these formats aren't very accessible right now. They typically require a phone, or in Amazon's case, an Echo device. Some of the app's experiences are only available for iOS or Android users, or are even limited to specific models of phones. In the game and film world, things are a bit better. Because game audio is already based on placing sounds in a 3D environment, it typically translates really well to immersive audio. Some games use these techniques natively, my favorite example being Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice.
I know what she's thinking. I hear her thoughts. It's not too late to get into the boat and go back. No one will judge her. No one will ever know. Oh, she heard us. There's no going back.
You can't do it.
Senua pushes away a world that conspired to cause so much suffering.
While others offer you the option to enable it in-game, and still others can be forced to support it using third-party plugins. This is where tools like Windows Sonic for headphones, Dolby Atmos for headphones, and DTS Sound Unbound come in. They take a surround sound signal and convert it to binaural audio. This also works for films and TV shows that are mixed for surround sound. Often visual media requires a receiver to decode the surround sound audio, but in this case, the software takes over that role. In Windows, it's really easy to enable these tools. Just right-click on the volume control, select spatial audio. Windows sound comes in the box, but in my experience, it's pretty awful. Dolby Atmos is much better, but it does require you to buy it after a short trial. That said, the cost is well worth it, in my opinion, if you enjoy this stuff. What about some of the other formats? Well, the big one is virtual surround headsets, which used to get a lot of buzz in the gaming world. They've pretty much fallen out of favor now and don't get a lot of press, mainly because you can experience this stuff on any pair of headphones by utilizing software. Overall, virtual surround is really complicated. Not because of the concept itself. The concept is really straightforward and really cool, and it works. The problem is there's so many formats and solutions for these techniques, and the end result really doesn't differ that much between them. Figuring out how to get your favorite media, whether it be games, movies, or music, into a binaural format is annoyingly complicated sometimes. It doesn't help that there's new formats and approaches coming out all the time. The newest big one is Sony's Tempest Audio Engine that they've implemented into the PS5. Overall, Tempest really isn't that different from existing solutions like Atmos. It's just another in a very long list of formats for experiencing virtual surround. I hope virtual surround becomes a lot more common and accessible in the future, but for now, it's all about digging through existing solutions to find one that does what you want. Hopefully, though, this video cleared up some of that and made things a little more straightforward for you. If so, please hit that like button. If not, feel free to hit the dislike button. If you have any questions or comments, or maybe specific topics that you'd like covered in a future video, definitely comment down below. And as always, if you want to see more videos like this, please hit that subscribe button.